Okay, so today I'm going to go ahead and show you what I kind of do on a daily basis. I'm going to paint you one of my expressionist abstracts. They help me relieve a lot of anxieties. I'm a very anxiety person. I'm not going to use any preliminary sketches or drawings or any photographs or anything like that. Sometimes I do to get kind of a feel, or I use my own artwork and I kind of try to mimic some of the other stuff that I do. But I'm going to go ahead and start this out raw. There's no preliminary, like I said, there's no thought in my head except for stress. I'm going to listen to some music real lightly to kind of get me in the mood, kind of mellow me out. Like I said, I'm a very hyper person. I'm very aggressive, and I think that's what I'm going to try to take out of my body and put into this. So let's get going. I'll share with you a little bit of what I do. Okay, so I'm not trying to get a standard body of a human being. I'm basically trying to feel my feeling, trying to express my feelings in shape of a human or alien form. Try to give you a feeling of what I'm feeling in my body, you know. So there's the kind of the beginning states. I know it kind of looks strange. Well, it's going to end up strange either way. But we're kind of trying to come with this here. So once I got this piece right here going on, kind of looking for those high areas. It's kind of how I started, just like that. Okay, and so then I'll plop that down and I'll find me a sketch brush. Nice little sketch brush. And I'll get my black paint that I keep in a bowl separately. And then I'll start doing this thing here. You gotta kind of feel it, you know what I'm saying? Numbers these days about symptoms and relief, but the number sufferers want most is zero, as in zero nasal allergies. Gonna do something really kind of what I'm feeling. It's just about. Unlike antihistamines that stop only one cause of your allergy symptoms, Nasacort stops more, and stopping more gets you closer to zero. For 24-hour relief of your worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, choose Nasacort. It stops more of what makes you miserable. Uses directed. So we can kind of see where we're going with here. There's a lot of process to this, so kind of we're just kind of filling in the feeling that I'm getting here. If you're a sleep apnea sufferer who's on the go to your phone and call right now to try the world's first portable mini CPAP device, absolutely risk-free for 10. Then we're gonna start carving it like a sculptor would do to his piece.
Transcend is FAA compliant too, so you can Call now. 1-800-900-0259. That's 1-800-900-0259.
Right now I'm putting like a highlight left on certain areas where the light would hit. Not too worried about it at this point. Just kind of want to intermingle colors because colors cause a lot of vibration of anger. Kind of what I'm after here so far. So when I do these characters, that's what I'm trying to get into this. So. So it's kind of what we're doing here, kind of creating this piece to where you're getting a lot of emotion. It's already starting to come out, see? That's what we're after. I mean, this is going to be a little bit of a change. We got to get some colors in there too, also to get the feeling. Okay, and also give a... One of my signature things that I like to do is put like red fingernails. These always get messed up during the pull, but that's okay because that's the next day. And I'll show you what I do with that layer here. Right now I'm just showing you an initial painting that I create. Stages of the painting. All this is going to have some really strange changes here. But we're talking about adding colors and taking away and adding and taking away. And that's where we're at here. Then we gotta add a little bit thicker because we know we're taking away some paint later on in the process. I'm liking it so far. Gotta strengthen a few areas like the wrist and the arm. So when you want to kind of strengthen some of your edges and your stuff that you do from the preliminary that you put down first. Okay, that's what you're looking for right there. Oh. I guess it's all about a takeaway and add thing after this. So, we're kind of liking what we got going on here. Okay, so it's representing your anger, or my anger that's inside of me. And then we're gonna start adding the background to block it in. It's very important you get around this with the right colors so it pops. I like to use brighter colors and then darker colors. But we kinda just get the whole canvas put in, and then we'll add some more stuff to it here as we go. So now we're gonna try to block it in, basically. It'll make the whole thing look different. Add some different colors, like green. Here's where the colors start popping in your figure and making a big difference. And as you can see, the colors ain't rich enough, so we've got to get it to where it's dark enough to where it's feeling the piece, you know? So combinations like orange into the greens cause an ugliness that pulls this figure out. Causes less obscurities in the work. So you can see it's also start coming together. I'm gonna get as close to the subject as I can because this brush is real flimsy, so it's what you want to do. You want to get as close as you can. Then you're gonna get a little bit of sharper brush. Try to get those edges a little bit closer. Miserable, stupid commercials. Oh. Okay, like I said, we're dealing with this right here. We're going to add juxtaposing tones such as red and green and combinations that they clutter the work, you know, they kind of cause a static. You can see already the whole thing's coming together with a lot of raw emotion. Remember, the strokes are important too because they cause a lot of emotion and anger. And that's what I like to do. I like to get that anger. I like, just get it out, you know what I mean? Kind of just get it out. You gotta feel it. Feel the paint. Feel yourself. Put yourself into this. Don't just paint to paint. Put your fucking emotion into it. Sorry about the cussing. Sorry, I just get with it, you know? Anyways, that's what we're after. Now I'll show you another little thing you got to do here that's very important that the old masters used to use. Once you get these kind of tones in place, your tone placement in place, you might have to readjust some things. See how it's coming out already? It's already doing what it needs to do. Like I said, you got those violent strokes. That's what you're after, these large, violent strokes that cause motion in the painting. See that? You hit it with long, angry strokes. Then you mix it with colors that don't harmonize too much. That causes another riff in the angry emotion. You don't want to use too much red, even though it does help with the green. Okay, Okay, so as soon as you're getting that to where you like it, start adding a little darker colors to the corners and around the tops. This will help box it in. That's what old masters used to do. See how it's starting to kind of contrast the whole thing in, starting to box it in like a frame. Darker colors do that. Using mystical colors like purple, black, with that, see into the greens. Not very important, but to talk about if you don't understand what I'm talking about. But anyway, just darken your corners. See how the corners I got darkened? It kind of boxes in your figure. Okay, as soon as that kind of process is done, you're gonna start refining it again. Just a little bit more, just kind of refine it here and there. You don't want to get rid of your spontaneity in the painting. You don't want to start getting too stiff or whatever. You want to keep everything loose. Okay, so I'm liking that so far. We're not done yet though. We're not close to being done yet. Now, when Van Gogh painted, he used to paint a lot of repetitive little strokes. These also cause these little choppy strokes like this cause a static effect. They break up large patterns and they also cause a lot of anger. He probably did it because he was nuts and, wait a minute, I'm nuts. Anyways, he probably did it because he liked to put an emotion of movement in his work. I'm doing it because it's causing a static. Breaks up the larger patterns if they're too taken away from the piece. So you gotta break them up. Like here's a piece right here I need to break up. We're just going to add some more greens to it. You don't want one solid area. Got to keep those colors moving. Keep everything vibration. Make sure your painting vibrates. See how that vibrates? No solidity, no solid shapes, just little choppy strokes. Nice clean movement. That's what you're after. How you refine it. Okay, and then I'm gonna kind of just get the back of my brush and kind of chisel it in. That's what I like to do. I like to chisel these areas in. And then what I'll do is I'll just do this to the eye. See how I did that? Okay, now we're ready for the next state. We take it off the easel. And here's where you gotta hold your breath, because I mean, you know what, I'm gonna add a little bit more refinement here too. I'm kind of jumping the gun here. Let me add a little bit more refinement here. I need to add a little bit of highlight here. Just a little bit. See, we got to get that stick out just a little bit more. When you do that pull, it's going to get rid of most of that. We got to have it there, though. There we go. That way it comes out, you know, you're getting that feeling, you're getting that emotion. See that? It's causing that anger. Blues, what do blues represent? Depression. So we got to get that in there. Sharp corners, edges, that also causes depression. Anger and all that can be shown very vividly through that. Okay, so you can see that's what I'm after. Finished areas, refined. Gonna give it some fruit hair. I don't know, what do you want to call it? Fruit hair? You know what I'm saying. Okay, everything's pretty good. We're gonna do some kind of a scratching. I gotta get a sharper brush here. We're gonna put like little weird stuff in it. Now this doesn't even matter if this shows up in the pool or not. It's not about that. It's about putting hidden symbology into the work. You're expressing yourself, your emotions, you're getting it out. You're getting it out of the painting. That's part of the whole process. There you go, doing that stuff. Look at that, see what I'm saying? Okay, so I scribbled a bunch of stuff in there. It all means something, but I'm not going to tell you what. That doesn't matter because it's going to get mainly covered up. So we're going to switch over here. We're going to switch the easel over to my table. This is my pool table. Not my pool table, but my pool table. That's when I do my pool method. What's happened to my lights here? Damn it. Oh my God, really? Okay, so my lights got messed up. Let's see what's going on here with this cord. Not ready for that. Anyways, this takes a long time. I'm just doing this process very quickly, but this is how I do these. Gotta look for little spots I forgot. Not a biggie. There we go. Okay, so like I said, I'm doing kind of a rush job, but I'm showing you guys what I do. So now I aim that on there. Okay. Kind of a pain in the ass, but now get the spray bottle. Now we're gonna spray the whole painting down. Spray it all good. But nice and lightly and evenly. Okay, and there's some spots that I'd like to redo right here, like, it's okay to redo them. Right here, on the head, and this wound, I kind of want to make a thick paint, and then we're going to go ahead and just squirt our bottle and make it run. See that? That's how it gives it life. Look at that, see? So that's part of the process. So now we're getting that point. Okay, now we got it nice and, see that so far? We wet it, spread the whole surface, now we're gonna do a pool. Now this is the part you gotta be careful for. Make sure my hands are kind of clean. It's gonna be a lot of adjusting and readjusting here. But I'll kind of just gently rub it. then I'll give it a pull, like, not straight, but kind of wiggle it. Here we go. Then I'll wipe this down. Shit, wasn't ready again. You gotta wipe your shit down, you don't want extra paint on there. And then you pull it again. You're looking for those pulls, that nice spot. There we go. Second one again. Let's see what I'm lap. Let's see what I'm after so far. So we're getting there. This is the scary process, because that's when you go fucking it all up. And then what I gotta do is go get more paint, kind of hit these areas again. Kind of cause myself more of a little problem than I need, but I'm just kind of refining some of the stuff we lost. So we're doing that. Kind of gives it that nice feel that we're looking for. It's kind of what we're out for, see that? And then, and we'll give it a, we're gonna give it a little creepier feel. It's got a red eye. Perfect. It's got a blue eye. Looks pretty good. We like the blue eye. It's got a little white to the blue eye. I'm going back and forth here. There we go, look at that. See what I'm after? That's what we're talking about. We're finding those edges. Okay, still working here with this. Gotta wet that horn. Gotta wet that horn. So we're after that fucking horn. Gotta be bleeding a little bit. Okay, we're liking that. Look at that. See how we do these? Okay, then I'll get my scratcher and we'll encapsulate it. Crosshatching marks into the piece to encapsulate the figure. We don't care if we go over the words, they're just hidden symbolic type of I guess you want to call it hidden messages, if you want to call it that, subliminal. It's about an impulse, it's about a feel. There we go. And then once we got to where we like it, we sign our name into it. I can get this hair off of here. Thanks everybody for watching this video. I hope I gave you some kind of insight to what I do. It's another thing I want to tell people when you're starting to do this, kind of know when you're done, just kind of quit. So I'm done. Thank you guys. Appreciate it. This will be online on eBay or my website. Thanks for all your support, guys. Love you.